For so quickly, I had 5 minutes. I was like, don't worry, it's fine, I only need 5 minutes.
What was it? Was it stodgy?
I just had eggs and bacon, I'm regretting every second of it.
That's gonna sit somewhere all day long.
Yeah, I was like doing a thing with GMTV and it's like...
Are you okay?
Oh yes, let's. Yeah. Let me get the top here. Robert Pattinson, welcome to Twilight Day on T4. Great to see you, sir.
I did not know it was Twilight Day.
You better believe it is. All day long, baby. And I just want to say, look at you, you big freaking movie star. One of our own, doing so exceptionally well. Give me some of that. Well done, sir. We're all very, very proud of you. You feeling good?
Yeah, I guess so, yeah.
Yeah, and you're back with another monster movie, quite literally. Mm-hmm. Are we still on track? Is it as good as the first? That's the main question. That's the first thing I need to open with.
Yeah, I think so. I think it will surprise people quite a lot as well, and how different it is from the first one.
Yeah, yeah.
So, I'm actually really looking forward to how people will react to it, because I don't think people will be expecting this movie at all.
How is it different, though? What will make people go, this is different?
I don't think it seems like a sequel. I don't even think the tone, everything, the soul of the film is completely different from the first one. And it's kind of, in a lot of ways, seems much more of like an adult movie. I mean, it doesn't seem like an adult movie. Well, it can be seen as that.
That's what the internet's for.
But it seems, you know, quite sophisticated and stuff, and it looks completely different. I mean, I don't know. Because I don't want to put down the other one, because I like the other one too.
But of course, I wouldn't let you put down the other one. But, you know, I'm sure it's going to, you know, continue to be this huge world-dominating franchise. And the franchise itself, it is everywhere. You know, you got your Twilight duvets, your soundtracks. I believe there's a selection of books you can read on the subject. Do they run these things past you? Are they like, Robert, check it out. It's the Twilight toothbrush. What do you think?
No, they don't run anything by me, which
that's disappointing.
I know, it is disappointing. Like, and it's annoying as well, because the image in New Moon is much closer to how I look in reality than it was in the first one. So now it's just like, yep, it looks like I'm endorsing everything. Like, and so, yeah, I was thinking of licensing out my image to my own stuff and just choosing the things so no one else wants their toothbrushes and things with their face on it. Just doing like horrible, grotesque sex toys and stuff.
I think they're already out there, to be honest. If you look them up, they're there.
But instead of an Edward Cullen one, I should do a Rob Pattinson one. And also, none of them work. They don't come with batteries and stuff. That'd be great.
Your character, vampire Edward Cullen, kind of sporadic in this movie. I mean, there was an hour where I hadn't seen you. I thought there was going to be a riot in the cinema. Yeah. I almost left. I was scared. Where were you?
You know, just around, just hanging out. in reality, he's going around the world searching for Victoria, who comes back at the end. But also just, I don't know, he does the equivalent of going on a massive bender, I guess, because he's
a bit down.
Yeah. I mean, and you know, when you can't eat and drink anything, he just kind of, I'm not entirely sure what he's doing, but he's doing something. He's doing something which you do when vampires are depressed.
But the good news is you come back, and that's kind of the main thing, to a big cheer in the cinema. It was emotional. I want to talk about Twihards. These people are incredibly devoted to yourself. Have you noticed them around? Lurking, the fans?
Sometimes. I mean, like in Paris yesterday, there are a few. But I mean, it's nice. I mean, the only time things get scary with fans is when there's just so many of them, and it just turns into like a kind of hysteria event.
It's like Zulu. They're just coming from the mountains.
That'd be fun. I love that scene.
I saw somewhere they'd printed photos of a toilet you've used.
Oh, really?
Really. That's nice, really toilet funny. As well, clean bowl, you put the seat down. I was very impressed.
But I mean, that wasn't me then.
That's gotta be pretty intense for a young man to take. I mean,
it is. I mean, it's a certain amount of acceptance. I mean, it's the only scary thing is that, like, it's not the fans of Twilight that are judgmental. It's like, just random general public who just read gossip magazines, even about people who they're not interested in.
Yeah.
They're the most supposedly puritanical, like, judgmental people.
Oh, yeah.
And so, it kind of affects, it actually does affect your career. Like, you know, if you, like, have a in a cup and then, you know, leave it in a hotel room, like, people get all, like,
what
antsy
you,
about it.
What are you
it.
Doing that for? I'm a little surprised.
The toilet was far away.
Let me ask you one last thing, because I spoke to Taylor earlier, and obviously there's a human vampire werewolf triangle at the heart of the new film. Taylor told me werewolves are awesome, pretty much, and vampires are just pasty old rubbish men. No, I'm going to give you the chance to get back at him. What are you going to say to him? Tell me why vampires are so freaking awesome.
At least I don't have to go around wearing denim hot pants to prove myself to anyone.
Boom. And I'm going to end the interview there. Perfect. Robert, great seeing you.
Thanks.
Cheers, man.